वेलकम बैक टू सिंपल स्ट्रेस एंड स्ट्रेन। टुडेज वीडियो विल बी विथ टॉपिक ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी। इलास्टिसिटी मीन्स एज वी यूज इलास्टिक रबर्स इन दैट फॉर्मेशन वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द मटेरियल्स। This is the property by virtue of which a body regains its original shape after the removal of external force is known as elasticity. So when external force acts on a body, the body tends to undergo some small deformation if the external force is removed. After loading, we will remove that external force. The body will try to come back to its original shape and size. So which means the deformation, whatever was occurred due to the external force, will slowly go on disappearing. So this type of body is having this elastic property. We call it as elastic body. So a material, any material, so let us consider a material which is said to be very much the elastic material, which can easily regain its shape and size completely, will be considered as first steel, then copper, then aluminium, brass, concrete, wood are considered to be perfectly elastic within certain limits, not extent of limit, for a certain limit. Certain limit means, example, if we take one particular pen, okay. So if I try to pull this side I am pulling, this side I am pulling. So both way there is a tension force acting. We are trying to pull it, but this material is also trying to restrain it into its position. So when I am pulling it, small amount of negligible deformations taking place, but as soon as I remove the loading, it will start to regain its original shape and size. So this regaining original shape and size is there for a certain limit. Certain limit, if I will try to pull it with a very force and holding with some huge or good gripping material and try to pull it, it will surely have the breakage. It will surely have the broken pieces into this, which will try to make that body cannot regain its original shape and size. So this way we can say that elasticity of a material and what is elastic body of a material. Note, a homogeneous material is one which is made up of same kind of material throughout, which will hold good elasticity. An isotropic material is one which has the same elastic properties in all the direction. So whenever we consider a material, we always say that a material should be homogeneous, a material should be isotropic, because it is having its own property. Similarly, when we come for the elastic limit part, so when it is the situation of taking the elastic limit part, so in this figure we are able to see that the ultimate stress, yield stress and strain, linear range, partial plastic, elastic, some points A, B, C, D, E, F, 1 is 0, 1 sigma, 1 epsilon. Clear? So what is this? So this is known as the graph when a particular steel, mild steel, is considered for the tension test. We are able to draw this, and with the help of this particular graph, I can make you to understand the elastic property of the material. So we can see the horizontal line, taken it as epsilon it is, and we call it as strain. So strain is change in length upon the original length. Similarly, the normal to horizontal line, perpendicular line, the vertical line, which we call it as sigma, is known as stress, which is the resistance of the material for the load acting on it. So when we try to plot this graph with stress versus strain, we will be getting somewhat a linear deformation line for this. How it is means stress is increasing, means load taking capacity is increasing, and similarly there is a small increase in the deformation, So this small increase in the deformation, we call it as a linear range, which is up to the point A, only up to the point A. So what is point A? So it is evident from the graph that the strain is proportional to stress. That strain is proportional to strain, or elongation is proportional to the loading giving at a straight line relationship. Means we can say that here stress is proportional to strain part it is going. Clear? So for you, sorry for this, this we can write it as the stress. Stress is proportional to the strain. So please make this correction that it is stress stress is proportional to strain, or elongation is proportional to the load giving straight line relationship. So this is about the point A. So when we are considering here, we say that it holds good in this position. So further, when we reach to point B, we get something called it as yield stress. What is yield stress? So in this part, we can also see that for a short period beyond the point A, the material may be still elastic, in the sense that the deformations are completely recovered when we remove the total load. This is the elastic limit. The limiting point B is termed as, or the point B, this point B is known as the elastic limit point also. So up to these two points, we can say that if we unload, we can easily see that it can come back to the zero point. Means the material from B point, if we remove the loading, it will directly come to regain its original shape and size, which was at this zero point. It is easily. So at this B point, whatever the amount of stress, means whatever the resistance of load on an area was there, that stress is called as yield stress. This stress is known as yield stress. Also, if we consider whichever the dimension or the material is there present in this particular A point, it is having the proportionality limit. Proportionality limit means Hooke's law is valid in this region, and at B point we say it as elastic part, elastic limit it is considered. Now going to B, to next point as C and D. So as we go on increasing the stress, we are going to increase the stress. Now what happens from B to C and C to D? So B, C and D, beyond the elastic limit, plastic deformations occurs. Plastic deformation occurs means there will be some kind of plasticity at this particular range, and here the plastic deformation occurs. Then comes, and strains are not totally recoverable. There will be a thus permanent deformation or permanent set. We call it as usually strain hardening point. This as usually strain hardening point, where it will take this place, D point. So this is strain hardening point where it cannot be completed. So in this strain hardening point, what it will be, these two points are termed as upper and lower yield points respectively. The stress at the yield point is called as the yield strength. So we can see this part, the whatever is yield strength. So B or CD, when we consider, it is yield stress at this point. That is not having more stress only. So strength as yield strength. Further, when we go to E point, well, now it is, we can see that the ultimate stress, which is at E point, how we are able to get, when we increase further stress, it is under in the partial plastic state. So it is going to increase. Further increase in the load will cause marked deformation in whole volume. It will be taking a whole volume of deformation of a material. The maximum load which the specimen can stand without failure means the material, whatever the material we are considering at this particular point, this point, the particular thing, whatever we are going to consider, it will not have any deformation in this part. It will just go on. Strain hardening is there, stress increasing is there. So strain hardening, stress increasing, at ultimate this point it will come and reach. So whatever this maximum point it is taking, there it will take the maximum load which the specimen can withstand, which can it can be easily carry without any failure, without a single part of failure. So without a single part of failure, this much maximum stress it can take. That maximum stress we call it as the particular ultimate stress at point. Further, when we start loading, so beyond point E, the bar begins to form neck. So how the form from this part, it is coming to downward direction. So what will happen? So see, simple thing, if this particular bar is given, okay, drawing is not so good, please just bear me, this bar is given. So let us consider this particular central part and how it will be. It will just forming a neck type like this. Okay, this is the bar. So we are able to, this part is this part, we will able to find this part of necking. So here what is happening, this much was the area, now the area reduction taking place, then this size is getting reduced. Now this will, if we take continue, it is getting elongated. It is now permanent deformation. It is under plastic deformation. Permanent deformation under plastic deformation. So this deformation we can say, so it is in the plastic range. It is in the plastic range. Plastic range it is. So we can't say anything. So here it is, strain is there, but stress is less. Strain is there, but stress is less. Change in length is there, but load taking capacity is less. Stress will be less. Okay. Now this particular part is taken as one kind of area. So this here we will find something called as true area of loading. So this we can say it is going increasing, this dotted line. So this dotted line is taking as true stress area, which we'll take to consider. So earlier the true area was this, it goes on reducing, only this much is remaining means only that part is going to remain now. Only this part is remaining now. There is no change in this part now. Only this much is remaining. Now, what happens in this remaining part? So, it will come and meet at point F. So, up to point F, what is completed? Partial plastic is completed. Partial plastic means, if it was something, it is in the plastic state, but it's partially. Partially means you are pulling it, then it is pulling. If you are not pulling it, it is hardened. So, it is not going to break. there it is under partial plastic and partial hardened state. So we call it as, for the convenience, partial plastic state itself only. Now in F, what will happen? Beyond E, the bar begins to form a neck. The load falling from the maximum until the fracture occurs at F. Clear? So now the load takes to have the fracture at F part. This is the until the fracture. So this was the graph of stress and strain for mild steel. So these points we need to remember: A point, B point, C point, D point, E point, and F point of the graph. Then comes elastic actions. How the elastic actions are going to occur? Elastic means what? Elasticity means what? Elastic limit means what? We have already seen. Now, how this is going to occur means how it will be acting on a particular material. It depends how it is. So elastic is an adjective meaning capable of recovering size and shape after deformation. Okay. And elastic range is the range of stress below the elastic limit. Clear? Below the elastic limit. So we can see here stress versus strain. First point A graph. Loading is taking. So loading, it is going. As soon as we release, it will come to unloading part. It is loading. When we unload, it comes to original shape and size. So loading, it is more. Unloading, it is less. So it differs. It may be a steel. When we come to a material called as a particular wood or any other material, so that time it is in a parabolic nature. So loading is there and again unloading is there. Loading and unload. So loading is what? This part is loading, the tension is taking place. Unloading is what? The again tension is taking place, but it is regaining its original shape and size. Clear? Now these two are occurring in the same line, though it is straight line and it is parabolic part. Now comes in the C part where loading takes place. So the loading takes place, and after we remove the load, it comes in unloading pattern in the other way, not in the same way the way it was loading. So this type is one of the part where it can come and join to its original shape and size, but not in the same way, but it may be in the different way. When it is taking unloading, maybe it may take a maximum deformation, or it may suddenly take a less amount of stress, this type. And the D part is when we are considering to load. So this is first point of load, one point. Here we will get one type of particular strain, a stress. It will have one part of strain, where in this limit the material comes totally to the zero, means it will regain its 100% back. But when it reaches to 2 point, one kind of stress is there. For that, it will come to some material where the strain is part of with proof stress. So here it may regain its shape, but not exactly as the earlier. When you similarly do it for the part 3, there also it will take some part up to this, and again it will not able to come back to 2 also. So you will have some other point as part 3. So this was the elasticity, elastic limit, and elastic actions and stress strain curve for elastic mild steel. Thank you. See you in the next video.